In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the path blur filter in Photoshop to add dynamic blurs. Okay, let's get started. We're gonna work with this image, and the first thing that we're going to do is select a soccer player so that we can work with them independently from the background. This is not going to be a selection tutorial. I do have a tutorial where I show you how to select almost anything using the Select and Mask workspace. I'll place a link down below in the description in case you're not familiar with selecting things in Photoshop. However, in this tutorial, we don't need to be very precise, so you can do two things. You can select the quick selection tool and click and drag over the soccer player to select them, or if you're in a newer version of Photoshop, Photoshop CC 2019 and newer, you can click on the Select Subject button and Adobe Sensei, Photoshop's AI, will automatically determine the subject of the image and select it. It does a really good job, as you can see. You can add to the selections in areas that it missed, like the soccer ball here and part of his hair. And you can hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click and drag to subtract areas that are selected that shouldn't be selected. I want to make sure that I am selecting the entire soccer player, but I don't want to spend too much time fine-tuning the image, so I'll use the small hack for that. I'm going to go into Select, Modify, Expand to expand my selection, and I'll expand it 3 pixels and press OK. The selection is now 3 pixels larger, and it seems like I'm selecting every part of the soccer player, which is what I want. You could also click on Select and Mask and maybe smooth the selection a little bit. I have the black and white view, which shows me my mask. Then I'll press OK. I just don't want any jaggy edges. Then with my background selected, I can press Ctrl J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate the layer. Now I have that soccer player on his own layer. Then I can right click and convert that layer into a smart object so that I can apply my blur non-destructively. I'm going to go into Filter, Blur Gallery, Path Blur. This tool allows me to create motion blurs along a path. You can control the shape and amount of blurring. Photoshop automatically composites the effect of multiple path blurs applied to an image. Let me show you what I mean by that. I have this path here by default. This is where the blur starts and this is where it ends. I can click and drag, and you can see that as I drag my path, the blur changes. In the center, you have this point that you can click and drag to curve the path. And if I click on the endpoint and hover over it, you can see this overlay. If you click and drag on the overlay, you can change the endpoint speed. You also have a slider here in the blur tools, which controls the same thing. Basically, when this is set to 0, the endpoint has no blur. Notice how all the blur is here on the start point, and there's not much of a blur where the path ends on his foot. You can create a path by clicking to create a point and clicking again and again, and Photoshop blurs the image along that path. You can click on the last point that you created to complete the path, and you can see that effect there. The controls in the blur tools control all the paths at the same time. So if I click on speed and drag, you can see how I'm controlling all the paths at the same time. However, if I click on an endpoint, this endpoint slider only controls that endpoint and not the second endpoint. To delete a path, you can simply select the point and hit the delete key or backspace on the keyboard to remove that path. I could also delete the original one and we can start from scratch. So what we want to do in this example is bring in dynamic motion to this image. I want to see the motion of his foot and his arm swinging out as he kicks the ball. So before you even start creating a path, think about how the blur would actually look like. His legs and his arms are doing most of the motion, so I'll start the blur on his hand and end it on his body. I'll click on this point to close that path, click and drag on this point to curve the blur. I also want to select the endpoint and bring the speed down to 0 because most of the speed should be up where his hand is since he's swinging out. I can also do the same thing for this leg. Click, click again, and click on the last point to close the path. I will also curve it, and I'll select the endpoint and bring the endpoint speed down to 0. And just with those two paths, I already created the motion of his arms swinging and also his foot swinging, this kicking foot. I could also create another path and see if that gives me any better results. Obviously, like anything else in Photoshop, you do have to do a lot of fine-tuning. In this case, I don't think I need so many paths. Even if I bring the endpoint down to zero, I'm not sure if I need that much blur on this foot. So what I'll do instead is just stick with the two paths. So I'll click on this point and hit the delete key to remove it. I think the speed is a bit high, so I'll reduce it right about here. And I think that I've created good motion to make it seem as if the soccer player is swinging his arms and swinging his legs. By the way, I want to point out the second option of the blur. We have rear sync flash, which simply means that the blur simulates the effect of a flash fired at the end of an exposure. So those are the two different options. For this example, we're going to stick to basic blur. Then I'm going to press OK. Remember that this is a smart object, which means that we're working non-destructively. You can always double click on the blur gallery label to edit the blur, but I think we have a good blur. What I'll do now is collapse the smart filters and just work with the layer. I'm going to hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click on the layer mask icon to create an inverted layer mask, a black layer mask, to hide everything in that layer. Then with the brush tool, I can paint with white. White is currently my foreground color, so when I paint, I can bring back that blur. So I'm selectively bringing the blur back. So I mainly want the blur on his legs and his arm. The advantage of working on a separate layer is that you can reduce the opacity if need be. And we also have a layer mask, so I can paint on the rest of the image and then take advantage of the fade command. If I go into Edit and Fade, I can fade my last brushstroke. So if I bring down the opacity, you can see how I fade that brushstroke. Also notice what's happening here in the layer thumbnail. Notice how that white stroke starts turning gray, which is what's controlling the visibility. So black is invisible, 100% white is visible, and then the different shades of gray are different levels of visibility. So you can just control that so that you have a nice blur and then press OK. Obviously, this is a very stylized effect, so it's something that you could use on a poster or any other type of design.